While submitting before the Parliamentary Committee of Legal and Parliamentary Affairs on the Law Revision Miscellaneous Amendments Bill 2022, the Attorney General Chiyowa Chiwanuka clarified that Parliament of Uganda has no powers to determine salaries of members of Parliament. Chiwanuka explained that within its powers, Parliament can't change the pay of legislators because it poses a financial implication on government.
Only Parliament that can determine even the remuneration of judges. You see, that's the thing, because it's only Parliament that can appropriate money. So not even the President can be paid without Parliament. You get what I mean?
In 2015, the Constitutional Court of Uganda declared Section 5 of Parliament, which mandates members of Parliament to determine their pay, unconstitutional and contravenes Article 93 of the Constitution. However, MPs believe that amendment of the law to align it with the court's decision is difficult, as it contravenes Article 85 of the Constitution and Section 5 of the Administration of Parliament Act, which states that emoluments of MPs are determined by Parliament. But Chiwanuka insists that although they can't change the law to remove powers from Parliament to determine MPs' pay, it remains a shared responsibility with the executive to decide emoluments of MPs.
So what we are saying here is that the spirit of the decision of the court is what we have lost. The spirit of what this judgment was saying is that it is a shared responsibility. Yes, that's what it was saying. So here, when we say government, parliament, you know, I got to this and I said, no, I need to leave this because I don't want to get onto the floor of parliament to have this conversation. If it were an amendment, I would write that this, I agree to substitute government with parliament, which shall be done through a bill brought by, so that we know that you approve because it's a shared responsibility.
Meanwhile, the Attorney General has called for a substantive amendment of the law on divorce to provide for same grounds of divorce in order to align the law with the 2003 court decision in Dr. Speciosa Wandera Kaziwe versus Engineer Charles Nsubuga Kaziwe, which decided that each ground for divorce is distinct and can be proved and sustained alone.
Clause 20, why did you maintain the requirement to prove in divorce proceedings more than one ground? Now, honorable colleagues, this is the most classic example of where I, as Attorney General, need to draw the line of how far I go. The court did not declare Section 4 of the Marriage Act, of the Divorce Act, unconstitutional.
As per the current law, a husband can apply by petition to the court for dissolution of his marriage on one ground of adultery by his wife. But a wife needs more than one ground to file for divorce, including when a husband changed his profession of Christianity for other religion, or when he is found guilty of incestuous adultery, bigamy with adultery, adultery coupled with cruelty, among others.
This is a matter that should have been a substantive amendment. This is the kind of thing, because the court has given the legislature a principle. You see? Whereas reform and review deals with removal. It says remove or delete this word or delete that word. You know? So the committee will have to look at this particular clause and guide.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.